In this next chapter on muscle tissue, we are going to start by going over the structure of muscle tissue, mainly skeletal muscle, but a majority of this chapter will be focused on function, so there's going to be a lot more physiology than we've had so far. Let's start by going over the three types of muscle tissue that should be familiar to you from the tissues chapter. There's skeletal muscle. This is muscle that attaches to our skeleton that allows us to move around through tendons. It's voluntary, which means that we consciously decide to contract these muscles to move. Skeletal muscle is multinucleate, meaning each muscle cell, which we call fiber, has more than one nucleus. It's striated, meaning it has a striped appearance. And these are long cylindrical cells. Skeletal muscle is the only type of muscle tissue that is voluntary. Smooth muscle is our organ muscle. This muscle exists in the walls of our visceral organs. Each smooth muscle cell has one nucleus, and smooth muscle tissue is involuntary. The same with cardiac muscle. Although it is striated like skeletal muscle, it is involuntary like smooth muscle, meaning we don't consciously contract these muscles. This happens automatically. And cardiac muscle have something that no other muscle tissue has, and that's intercalated discs, which we don't really see here, but these are connections between cardiac muscle tissue cells that allow information to flow very quickly from one cell to another so that the cardiac muscle tissue could contract altogether uniformly as for an effective pump. Muscle has four properties. The first being excitability. Only muscle cells and nerve cells have this property. That means their plasma membrane can carry electrical charge. We call those impulses or action potentials, and that's how information flows through our body. Let's go to three. Extensibility means that muscle tissue can be stretched. And after it's stretched, it has another property called elasticity, which means it can return to its original length. And the final muscle property is unique to only muscle tissue, contractility, or it can contract or shorten with force. So these are four properties that you should know for muscle tissue. So now let's organize skeletal muscle. Here's one large skeletal muscle. Looks like it's a large thigh muscle because there's the femur. Regardless, your whole muscle is surrounded by a connective tissue layer right here called epimysium. If we look inside of a muscle, we see that it's made up of all these small sections. Each little section of muscle is called a fascicle. And each fascicle is lined with connective tissue, which we call perimysium. Peri meaning around. Now, if we enlarge one fascicle, like we did right here, we pulled out a fascicle and magnified it, we can see that each fascicle is made up of small sections. Each one of those sections is a muscle fiber, and a muscle fiber is a muscle cell. The muscle fibers are wrapped in connective tissue, which we call endomysium. So we have three levels of organization, from the whole muscle to the cell, which is the muscle fiber. Epimysium surrounds the whole muscle, perimysium surrounds the fascicle, and endomysium surrounds the muscle fiber or muscle cell. At each end of a whole muscle, we have a tendon that connects it to bone. We don't see the other end, but there'd be at least one tendon at this end as well. The tendon is the epimysium, perimysium, endomysium, continuing even though the muscle cells or muscle fibers end about this point. So the tendons are a continuation of these three connective tissue layers. Now we are looking at just one muscle fiber. If I go back here, this was a muscle fiber that's wrapped in endomysium. Well, that's where we're starting on this slide. So this is one muscle cell, which we call a muscle fiber. Its plasma membrane is called the sarcolemma. And in this chapter, we'll see a lot of sarcos and myos, which have to do with muscle. Remember that muscle cells are excitable, right? And that's where the lemma comes from, a sarcolemma. Yeah, it's a plasma membrane that allows electrical impulses to flow through it. Inside our muscle fiber, we have all these tiny cylinders, which we call myofibrils. There's the name right here. If we enlarge one myofibril, we'll see that it's made up of all these little rods, which we call myofilaments. The thick ones are myosin. Those are thick filaments. And the thin ones in green are actin, which are thin filaments. Here we can see it labeled. So these myofibrils, each one of these small units in muscle fibers, is made up of contractile units. From this Z disc to this Z disc is one contraction unit. We call that a sarcomere. And a sarcomere contains the thick filaments, myosin, in the center, with the thin filaments, actin, overlapping from each side. When we look at a muscle fiber under a microscope, we see it striped. It's striated. We get light bands and dark bands alternating. Well, the light band, which we can see right here on either side of the Z disc, looks lighter because there's less myofilament there. That is called an I band. You can see that here too, or the dark band, which is the length of myosin, is called the A band. A good way to remember that is light has the letter I in it, dark has the letter A in it.